moving from one place to the other all the time. They had many different chateaus, and here you see the main gate, which has on both sides the eagles, which were the emblems of Napoleon. We visit
stays with the bus, I think all.
Not at all.
Decoration we saw in more than 10 years. Finally, the kids wanted to have a large, which is a part of the apartment, which was used sometimes by some of the ladies in waiting, the queen. And it had been used in the 16th century by one of the mistresses of Key, as they were originally. There's a beautiful handrail.
Which was
submissions. The whole space was for people wanted to do. Not for the most part anymore.
These were supposedly done by Pintaricchio, who stayed here.
Now this gallery, this room, which is very, very ornate, was only the guard room. And it's extraordinary to see this built for decoration, the wood panels on the bottom, as it is usual, and the painting in the city. Notice the city itself on the wall. The city itself is very interesting, because it's quite typical of the cities in the chateaus for a short period, under Henry IV and Louis XIII. In some small shack architects in the ancient part. The value of the chair menu is a feature for Britain. Not ordinary, but more simple houses, you find those in Mahogany. Because they represent the four seasons, so this is the spring. Originally, those four tapestries were in Versailles, and they were transferred here, and I guess the fifth one. And this is the This is the library now. Staircase. Now this gallery and then the little tiny room, which were part of the Queen's apartments with the two rooms of the Revolution. But the furniture was made a little later. This is typical furniture of the early period of Napoleon, with the impression of the statue of Pasolini. But it's just painting, it's absolutely flat, even the pieces above the doors in white and blue. Mm. Now the furniture is also dating back to the time of the Napoleon, except that the velvet on top is brand new, as you can see. There is an interesting table in the center, which is entirely made of china or silver. This was made at the time of Napoleon, and Napoleon has several tables made of the same style. The manufacture of silver was founded by Louis XV in the 18th century. This was when they discovered the kaolin in France. We are living in those days. We are happy. This is the bed, which is really queen size. And you notice those beds are so high that they have some steps to them. But because it seems they were transported to the room during the revolution and brought back here because they were made for this studio. They make some exchanges. And it was a public service. And now we're going to reach a section which is still on course of restoration, redecorated and refurbished. Napoleon never used the king's apartments. He was all set in the throne room. The little kingdom of Fountainebleu. So you find this Fountainebleu only after the early 17th century. After Henry IV, the things are much easier with the 13th, with the 14th, with the 15th, with the 16th. You know? The date for
Mark orange.
Oh, here's a peacock.
Ah. I'm coming for you, buddy.
Do your stuff, guy. Pick it up. There you go.
There you
Come
go.
On, that's a boy.
All together, I mean.
But sometimes.
What a show off. Hello, sweetheart. You're looking beautiful with gorgeous Chateau Fontainebleau.
So, you look like a teacher.
That's right.
The War Memorial of the First World War.
And next to the little chapel, which is behind, there was the studio.
Barbizon.
Have a part of the group going straight back to the bus.